Good morning. I'm going to explain, I'm going to present today Apache Arrow and DataFusion and how that's changing the game for implementing database systems. So my name is Andrew Lamb. I'm a staff engineer at InfluxData. I'm also an Apache Arrow PMC member, and I've been involved with the project about 2 years. My background is in query optimization in databases. I worked at a company called Vertica and also at Oracle on those servers. And I've also spent time in executive roles in a bunch of startups. So what I wanted to do is I went to Hacker News today, or maybe it was, I don't know, a week or two ago. And I just looked like new database. And it seems like there's like a new one every day or every 2 days or whatever. And pretty soon, this is only some sampling that I got, very biased. You know, you get your name database here. And so the question is, what in the world is happening? And why are there so many databases occurring? And of course, I'm going to try to explain why, so that then when I explain what DataFusion is, I think that's part of both the reason why and also the reason why it's so easy today. So what in the world is going on? I think we're going from a mode in the past where we bought software in like an IT mode, right? We kind of like bought software from a vendor and operated this. This is actually basically what I spent my career doing, is writing software for the vendors, then someone would buy it and then operate on their own machines. Along the way came systems, people like FANG, which I mostly like to use because I like the acronym, but that stands for Facebook, Apple, Netflix, Google, but it's basically the big internet companies. And what they do is they tend not to buy from vendors. They instead tend to write software for themselves, optimize exactly for their use case, and then operate it. So they do the whole life cycle. And they're big enough and they have big enough reach that they can do that. But I think the rest of the industry is kind of headed in that direction, and basically towards specialization. So you can see that what people are tending to do now, especially sort of startups and people who are running, building new services, they tend to assemble and operate these new systems. So they assemble them from various open source technologies. I think this is part of where Arrow and DataFusion fit exactly. And then they operate on sort of some public cloud. So basically even small companies now are able to follow the same execution model that was once only available to the internet biggest internet companies. So I also wanted to give a shout out here. This is not something new. There's actually been a long-term trend in database specialization over the last maybe 20 years. It used to be like a couple of big ones like Oracle, DB2, SQL Server. And in the last 15 years, you've seen there's a huge proliferation in different data models, not just relational, right? There's a whole bunch of NoSQL variants, various ways to deploy databases like on the cloud, in the edge, single node hybrid. I'm not going to read all this to you. Various specialized ones for different types of use cases and whichever ecosystem you happen to be in. And there's just a whole bunch of them, right? So this is something that Professor Michael Stonebreaker basically predicted almost 20 years ago, and it's basically coming to pass. So with that as background of where DataFusion comes from, maybe I'll talk a little bit about what it actually is and where you do it. So I'm not going to read this entire slide, but if you've ever tried to build a database system, and I've done it once, and I'm in the process of doing it again, when you start, you don't necessarily realize, if you haven't done it, how many things are required. So this is like some brief timeline where I tried to brainstorm the things you might need to do, right? So you come up with the idea of let's building a database, and then as you go along, you have to come up with in-memory storage for it and catalog, figure out where the tables are. If they do a basic type system, then you typically implement filter and aggregation. You need a query language parser, and you need to arithmetic and various other things. And only then you get to the point where like you have something that people would recognize like a database. But this first part takes a non-trivial amount of time. Like when we were doing it at Vertica, it took approximately 8 engineers, 2 years or something like that to get the basics here. And then you actually have a significant journey is still ahead of you where you start adding more sophisticated systems like various storage rearrangement. You realize date time expressions are far more complicated than you ever imagined. Joins add a huge amount of complexity. Maybe you probably want to do distributed query execution, resource management, all this other stuff. And only at the end, like now, right, you're pretty happy. But this is a huge investment, right? So if you're trying to build a specialized system for your use case and you don't have the resources of a giant company, this looks pretty daunting. So I think this is exactly where DataFusion and Arrow come in. DataFusion is the point of this talk, but Arrow is a bunch of the lowest level stuff. So I just tried to like write little check marks here, right? Like if you look at this timeline of what you have to do to implement a database, it's a huge amount of it that Arrow and DataFusion together give you along the way. So you can start, right? So you already start with, you know, Arrow at its core is the memory storage model. It ends up also having basic operations, and it's also been branching out into various, other parts, basically filling out this timeline. And so that's Arrow. DataFusion, I'll talk about a little bit more, is built on top of Arrow and sort of fills out the toolkit focused on databases, not just the in-memory representation of the arrays. So, you know, it has things like a query planner and I'll talk about it, but it lets you fill out this. So that's basically the pitch, right? So if you're going to build a specialized database, stuff like Arrow and DataFusion really lower the barrier to doing it. So let's spend a few minutes talking about exactly what DataFusion is, or maybe a little bit more in detail, right? Obviously, if you look at the introductory material from the website, which I just copied, it's written in Rust. It talks about Arrow, it's in memory format. But what is that really? So what is a query engine in particular? So input-output diagram of a query engine tends to look like you give it data, in this case, it's record batches from Arrow, probably described as though it was a table. And then the query engine lets your users provide a query either by SQL or maybe a data frame interface that describes what they want, and they don't want to be bothered with the details of like how exactly to go calculate the result. You know, they just want the summary information of user activity over some period of time aggregated such and such a way and sliced and diced, whatever. So, you know, the main reason to have a query engine is to detach the description of what you want calculated from the actual details of calculating it. So that's what the query engine does. You can build databases with that and a whole bunch of other stuff. But that is its core, what DataFusion lets you do. And it adds a lot of things there. So if I may take, you know, I'll switch gears here a little bit, because you can think about DataFusion as a query engine, like I just talked about. You can also think about it as an infrastructure thing, right? Or a toolkit for building databases. And so here's how I think about this, right? So LLVM, which stands for low-level virtual machine, if you're not familiar with it, but it's basically the backing technology behind Clang and Rust, C, and a bunch of other languages these days. And really what it was born out of the observation that a lot of the compiler infrastructure was, you know, previous to this, if you wanted to implement a new language or you wanted to implement a new sort of hardware instruction set, you basically have to write the compiler from, you know, ground up. So people like, so big companies like Sun Microsystems could actually do that, where they could write the compiler and the hardware and everything in between. As people realized how much of a job that was, they wanted more, you know, interesting new languages, and they wanted to be able to add new technologies, the LLVM became a thing. So that basically standardizes most of the common pieces that you would need to build a new programming language and a new backend. And now the cost to like adding a new instruction set that you might want to target, or adding a new language front end, is much lower because you can take advantage of all the existing sort of LLVM and classic compiler optimizations. So you don't have to go re-implement it all yourself. So that's LLVM. So, you know, I like to think about, well, DataFusion is kind of like the same thing for databases. Inside DataFusion, what does it have? Well, it has query front ends. So I talked about that. What that really means is it's got code that translates SQL queries or stuff from data frames into logical plans. You can think about this, if you're familiar with LLVM, as a, you know, like a type of intermediate representation. Databases also tend to have different definitions of data sources and how to find them. So I think that's another sort of input to DataFusion. Then query engines, every query engine I've worked on, much like LLVM itself, has like a logical plan, which describes a data flow graph, which is how the system will go calculate your results. There's typically two versions of those plans. There's one that looks closer to the original query, and there's one that looks closer to the actual execution. So DataFusion has that split logical plan, execution plan. And then you've got the actual code that goes and computes various quantities and calculations and influence the underlying algorithms, like expression evaluation or grouping or hashing or joining or sorting or whatever. So DataFusion has all these, so that's cool. I think what's probably cooler to me and why I think it's a game changer is because DataFusion has been designed to let you plug in and extend basically any of these points. So you can add your own data sources, you can add your own SQL front end or front ends for your own languages, right? So I'll talk about some uses in a moment. You could add your own logical operators because depending on what language you might want to be computing things in, you that might or might not have corresponding operators or in a classical database. Optimizations, transformations, you can use the standard ones built into DataFusion, but also that's extendable. Likewise, you can extend at the lower level plans, and you can actually extend the underlying execution operators as well. So you basically plug in wherever you want, use what DataFusion has as a base and extend it to your needs. So I think in conclusion, I just want to give an example of like the kinds of, that might all be kind of theoretic. So let me tell you some examples of what people are actually doing with this thing. So there's a company called CubeJS. They have a product that does headless business intelligence. I'm not 100% sure what that means, to be totally honest with you, but it sounds pretty cool. And they have a pre-aggregation storage layer so that when they're doing the BI operations, that they are able to answer the questions very, very quickly. So that pre-aggregation storage layer is built on top of DataFusion, and it accepts SQL. It also has custom logical and physical operators for their particular use cases, uses custom functions, and runs with a DataFusion optimized plan. So it's an example of they use some of what comes with DataFusion. They've also extended it with for their own needs. It's a very similar story for actually my project. This is called InfluxDB IOX. That's the next generation storage engine we're building at InfluxData. But it's an in-memory columnar database that's focused on the time series use case. But under the covers, it uses DataFusion to anytime it touches data. So that's for both for query and for physical reorganization. And likewise, we use sort of a whole bunch of the extension points to extend DataFusion so that we can implement our time series specific queries and also our other uses. So yeah. There's also one of these cool things, actually LLVM originally was a academic project so that people could try out new optimization techniques. So actually it's kind of cool to see DataFusion being used in academic projects as well. So that's what this is. It's called Flock. It's from UMD databases groups, and they're doing research on running databases on these function as a service type systems. So like things like AWS Lambda. And they're trying to experiment to figure out the best way to implement databases on top of that execution model. And so rather than have to build a whole database infrastructure from scratch, these guys use DataFusion so they can run SQL, and then under the covers, they end up targeting it to run on a flock of function as a service machines. DataFusion is another interesting one. These guys that's basically part of Vega Fusion is a custom data transform language. So it's basically a custom query language and visualization language that's built into this platform. And so this project uses DataFusion's data frame API to do the translation. So basically they have a custom query front end that they translate into DataFusion's plans, and then UDFs to implement Vega specific expression. And then they use the native execution operators to actually build calculate the results. So yeah, so I think it's a pretty cool project. I think another thing that makes it significant is that we have a significant contributor count. Another thing that I really love about DataFusion is that its community is much like the Rust community, is very active and welcoming. I think in general, we've been encouraging contributions from all levels. And we've had people, who are database internals experts like myself, and know even more, to people who are like just starting with Rust and everyone in between. So basically, if you're looking to sort of either get some experience writing Rust or learn something about database internals implementation, it's a great place to come and check it out. So I'll leave you with, there's some website links here that go to the actual project, right? It's all open source. It's run under Apache. It's actually run under the same project that manages the Arrow project. And there's a lot more technical detail both on those websites. And then there's another link to some slides here. So thank you very much. And I hope you enjoyed it. Check it out.